Hello and welcome to Kitty Corner. All right, today I'm going to be showing you how to feed and water your cat. Now, first things first, you're going to want to take the food bowl and lift it up. You're going to want to lift it up out of its spot and put it on a new spot, preferably on an elevated setting. One second. Okay, now I have my kitty's food dish and I'm going to set it down. This way, when you are pouring the food, you will not accidentally pour it on your cat's head. And if this were to happen, well, it would just be a great tragedy because then food would go spilling everywhere, it would go all over the floor, you'd have to bend down on your hands and knees and pick it up. Because everyone knows that cats do not eat food that was on the ground. That's just common sense. So, now I have my bowl and I have my food. I'm going to take my food, I'm going to open it. Now, when I open it, I'm going to have one side, and I'm going to grab the one end with my one finger, or with my one hand, excuse me, and I'm going to take the bottom end, I'm going to grab the top with one, and take the bottom with the other hand, and that way I can lift the bottom so that eventually it is higher than the end with the opening. And then when that happens, ready? And food. Now you're going to want to keep it there steady. You might have to keep lifting it just a bit. And once the food reaches the top, you're going to want to lower the bottom end so that it is lower than the end with the opening. That way, the food will start coming out and you can properly seal your bag. Okay, now if you do not stop the food when it reaches the top, food will overflow the bowl and you will just have food everywhere and that'll be a mess. This will require some time and some practice. You might want to practice with fake cat food first. Okay, now that I have my cat food filled, I can set it back down. Now, when I set it back down, I'm going to want to put it in the same spot. That way, Kitty can find it. If I don't put it back in the same spot, Kitty won't find it. Kitty will go around. It will wander and meow and wonder, where's my food? Meow, where's my food? Because everyone knows that cats are dumb. They're just stupid creatures. And this also is common sense. It's just that simple. Cats are dumb. So, now, when I take the food, I'm going to want to put it back in the same spot so Kitty can find it. And, like I said, if you don't put it back in the same spot, Kitty won't look for it. Cats don't look for their food. They won't bother to look where it is. They just bother to look to where they think it should be. And so, this way, I will successfully have fed my cat. Now, here I go. Now, that's step one. Step two is you're going to want to give your cat water. Cats like to, once they start eating, just like humans, they like to wash down the food with a tasty beverage. And cats drink, just like everything else on planet Earth, cats drink water. So what I'm going to want to do is pick the water bowl up off the ground, much like the food bowl, and I don't want to bring the water to the bowl. Okay? I don't want to take that step of bringing the water to the bowl, alright? Because then, just like the food, water's going to get on your cat, the cat's going to be wet, cats don't like water being on them, they don't like to be wet, it's going to freak out, scratch you, okay? We don't want cat scratches, okay? We want cat hugs. We don't want scratches, we want hugs. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the bowl off the ground and bring it to the water, okay? Alright, now that I have my bowl, I'm going to bring it to my water. Now, you can have a running faucet or you can have a jug, a big jug of water. But it's a lot easier if you have running water. Okay, now what I'm going to want to do is lift the lever. Okay, some faucets are like this. others aren't. Your house may have a different faucet. Hopefully you have already read your instruction manual for your faucet properly and you know how to use it. Okay? Otherwise, you should stop watching now and you should go do that. Alright? And what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to want to get a steady flow of water. Alright, now I'm going to place the bowl under that water. Alright, now much like the food bowl, I'm going to want to watch. Okay, now it's almost reached the top, and once it does, I cut off the water supply, and now I have a full bowl of water. Okay, now, you want to try to be careful and not get your fingers wet. Alright, because if you do that, you're going to have to wash off your fingers. Okay, now, much like the food again, it's amazing how similar the two are. Okay, it's really all you need to do is remember step one in step two, but just replace food with water. Okay, I'm going to want to lower the water back on to the cat's favorite spot. Okay, and it might not be the cat's favorite spot, but it's going to be the spot that hopefully the cat knows where it is. And I'm going to lower the water. Okay, now the water and food bowls are full. Okay, water and food has been put into the bowls, and now the cat has food and water. Now, that's step one and two of how to feed and water your cat, but there's also a step three. There is giving your cat treats. Now, if you do not give your cat treats, your cat will not know that you love it. So what you're going to do is you're going to take your index finger and your thumb. You're going to take your other index finger and your thumb, and you're going to sort of pinch and pull, okay? And when you do that, your bag will open, and you will have cat treats, okay? Now, you will want to lift the one end higher than the end with the hole, and get about 3 to 5 treats, okay? And once you get about 3 to 5 treats, if you get too many, you want to put some back. If you don't get enough, you want to do the process over. Okay, now, once I have my treats, I'm going to want to close my bag by pinching and securing the bag. Okay, now it's secure and the cat's treats are safe. Now, 3 to 5 treats depending on how much you love your cat that day. So, 3 to 5 treats will make your cat love you for approximately 20 to 30 minutes. I'm going to want to put the treats down by the food. That way, the cat will know where to find them. All right, here we go. All right, so now we have successfully fed our cat. Isn't that delightful? So, now you know how to feed your cat. And thank you for joining me, Dr. Chef Daniel Cooper, on Kitty Corner. Next week, we will be going over how to pet your cat. And what not to do with your cat, such as not sticking it in a microwave. And as they say in Kitty World, have a good day. Meow.